Everybody, Lloyd and Roger Williamson here. This is our weekly guitar broadcast. Thanks for joining us. We're trying a few different things today than we've done on other broadcasts. This is pre-recorded, so we can't respond to you in real time, unfortunately, but I know some people that said hi last week. Doug Dan and all. Doug, I know you're watching. We know. Linda Dunlop.
Hi, Linda.
She'll be there. Guaranteed. Okay, so a few things have happened this past week. Thanks to everyone, if you're following us online, thanks to everyone who sent in messages of concern about my injury. I cut my fingers on some broken glass last week, and you know, as a musician, we hate that. Like, just, I said suddenly, what, I'm covered in blood, and what is this? Oh no, and I realized what had happened, and I'm kind of saying, please let that be any other part of my body almost, other than my hands. So I was out of commission, couldn't play, went to the hospital, etc. No stitches, so they were able to fix it up, and we're down to just these two small bandages now, so, and I can hold pick again, so there's that. Okay, so we're going to play some songs here today for you. Let's do, I don't know, do you want to do 5 foot 2?
Sure, yeah. Let's play that in C maybe.
Okay, we don't rehearse these, so this is just the way it is.
I'll just start off, I guess.
Okay, let me just do this. I got it, okay. Thank you. good old favorite 5'2". So we write down what do we need to tell the people about? Oh, about this guitar I'm using?
Oh yeah, that one.
I'm struggling a little with it. Not that it's not a good guitar. It's great. This was here, I'll come up close. This was a custom build that had done for me. There's a story behind it. I'll abbreviate the story. It's a family farm that we basically grew up on. Well, you didn't, but you were an adult when you went there first. It's near where we live, and it's been in the family for a long time, and it was Grandma and Grandpa's farm, and now it's owned by my aunt and uncle, and it's still in the family. And there was a massive elm tree that towered over the farm, right on top of the hill, and the farm was named the Lone Elm after that tree. It unfortunately succumbed to the Dutch elm disease only a few years ago and had to be cut down. And it was a sad day on the farm, but they counted the rings of the trees, and it was well over 150 years old. So the farm doesn't look the same without that there. But all of the family got pieces of wood from that tree that people could do whatever they wanted with. So people were making furniture. So I had a guitar custom built. And here, I'll show you this. Elm isn't really the best instrument wood, as any instrument maker will tell you, but it had some sentimental value. So the elm, I'll show you the finish on this. This was done by a luthier friend of ours named Daryl Hyde. And he made the body and did the electronics. And they're just stock Fender electronics. And the neck is actually made out of maple. And it was done by our good friend, bass player and luthier, Dean Cable. And we were lucky enough, I hope that shows up on camera, to get a picture of the Lone Elm. And if you wonder whose signature that is, that's my grandpa's, Austin Brown. And I've got a couple of cool pictures of Grandpa Brown. And since we're pre-recording this, I'll post them up here. I'll put it right here. Point here. Point to where my finger. Right, it's there. Grandpa Brown. That's on my mom's side of the family. Your father-in-law. Mm-hmm. And he's gone now. And I think I have one picture of him in his younger years and another one that was in his later years.
Yeah, I have a few around here, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Good. Well, we'll put them all up there so everybody can see it. And if we've missed any, we can... we can put them in comments for sure. So this is the Lone Elm guitar. So I'm still, it's good. As with any new instrument, you're still getting used to it. It plays great, but it sounds different than the one I'm used to. Mm-hmm. So I noticed when I turn the volume down, the tone changes. So when I turn down to play rhythm for you, that's why I'm going, so I'm going to use the volume pedal instead. Because it freaks me out when that happens. Say the last dance for me. Let's do that.
Okay, you can start part one.
What key do you want? A. Thank you. part on that.
Yeah, me too, I guess.
You know, some versions of that didn't have that B part on it.
Maybe that's why I didn't think of it.
Yeah. Big loss in the musical world. David Crosby died this past year, this past week. So sorry to hear that. Just sad news, but needs to be a tip of the hat to him for a lifetime of music. Okay. So let's do Cold, Cold Heart.
Okay, maybe E.
You can, an E?
I think so, yeah.
Do you want an intro for it?
Sure.
Album Joe Pass and Roy Clark play Hank Williams. Yeah, they did one together. It's incredible. It's great because Joe has incredible jazz stuff, and Roy has some of the jazz stuff mixed with some of the country stuff that he does so well. And it's just the whole thing is really good. I don't know if anybody else there has that album, but all Hank Williams.
I have to listen to that.
I'll lend it to you.
All right.
Here's an idea. Dad and I were just talking about this. We can go and broadcast from your house. If you want to give somebody a really unique present, get Dad and I to go to do this show from their place. We'll do it. We'll show up, bring very minimal equipment, and eat all their food, and just have a good old time, and the show will be done from their house. Easy to do. So, we'll go anywhere. Doesn't matter where it is. Okay, so let's do one more tune.
Okay.
Let's do the other Hank Williams tune we're going to do. Hey, good looking.
Oh, okay. Maybe A for that one?
Okay. Are you going to start it?
Yeah.
Are you going to start it?
You start it.
Okay, from the two, I'll play an intro. Okay. No, I'll just play it right from
here. Yep.
Okay. Two. One, two, three. Tuning in.